you go to bed. Come on now, sit still. Come on, Ricky, sit still, honey. Now, Mama's got to...
Come on, honey, I'm hungry.
I'm ready. We can go as soon as Mrs. Trumbull gets here.
Hey, where are we going to eat?
We're going to meet the Mertzes at that French restaurant.
What French restaurant?
The new one, the one the Applebee's told us about, you remember?
Okay, I'll go and see what's keeping Mrs. Trumbull.
Okay, listen, Carolyn said that the menus were all written in French. Do you know how to read French?
Sure, I can read it.
Oh, good.
But I can't understand it.
Oh, great. Well, listen, Ethel took French in high school, and Fred was in France during the First World War. Let's let them order, and then we'll take what they take.
All right.
There's Mrs. Trumbull.
I'll let her in. Good night, old man.
Say good night, Poppy.
Good night.
Say good night, honey.
Good night, boy.
Take your blanket. Here we go. Now I want you to go right to sleep for Mrs. Trumbull. You lie down now, honey. You go right to sleep for Mrs. Trumbull.
What time they say they'd meet us here, Ethel?
Oh, they ought to be here any minute.
Well, I'm hungry.
So am I. Well, let's see what looks good. Fred.
Yeah?
This menu's all written in French.
Well, what did you expect in a French restaurant?
But there's no English on it.
Let me see it. Where's the English here?
Where?
Right here. Acme Printing Corporation. Union Shop.
Oh, very funny.
Well, I ought to be able to figure out something on this thing. After all, during the First World War,
I was stationed in France. I know.
Well, I was.
You were there exactly 3 weeks.
Well, I learned a lot.
I know everything you learned, and they don't serve hickey dicky parley booey.
Well, I'll just ask the waiter to tell us what these things mean. Hey, Garkin!
I know what we'll do. We'll wait till Ricky orders, and then we'll say we'll have some of the same.
Well, what makes you think he can speak French?
Well, he speaks Spanish, and all those foreign languages are practically the same.
Oh. Wouldn't you think I'd recognize something on this thing?
Oh, hi.
Oh, hi,
late, you know.
I'm sorry.
We were getting hungry, of course.
Oh, isn't this fun?
Yeah.
It's a real atmospheric type place, isn't it?
Yeah, I feel just like I was in Paris.
Bonsoir, monsieur et madame.
Bonsoir.
Gee, doesn't everything look delicious?
Mm-hmm. It certainly does.
What is madame's choice?
Well, it certainly is difficult to make a choice. What are you going to have, Fred?
Me?
Uh-huh.
Oh, I don't know. What are you going to order, Rick?
Well, I thought I'd have this... Oh, I beg your pardon. Ladies first. Go ahead, Ethel.
Oh, I haven't decided yet. Lucy?
Oh, no, you don't. I started this.
Well, now, is anyone ready to order?
Well, you go ahead.
You know, we could starve to death like this. Now, someone has to go first.
I would gladly go first, but I have already eaten.
Well, I know. I'll count. One potato, two potato, three potato, four.
Please, allow me. Une pomme de terre, deux pommes de terre, trois pommes de terre, quatre, cinq pommes de terre, six pommes de terre, sept pommes de terre, c'est tout. Ma mère m'a dit de prendre à vous.
Oh, well, that sounds good. Bring four orders of that.
Madame, I was counting. You must order first.
Oh. Oh, well, let's see now. I'll have this.
That?
Yes. I'll have the same.
Me too.
So will I.
Ah, madame, monsieur.
You heard our order. Will you please bring it?
Please, could I not suggest something else?
No, this is what we want.
Very well. Four orders of closed on Sundays. Please allow me. I will bring you this specialité de la maison.
Fine.
Un petit rôti, un des petits pains, et quelque chose de pommes de terre frites. Merci, monsieur.
Oh.